So let's talk tactics for the trusty chicken walkers of the Astra Militarum, let's talk Sentinels and the new Guard Codex. Hello and welcome back to Warspecs Tactics, where today we're talking Imperial Guard once more, and today we're going to be looking into the Sentinels in a bit more depth and doing a unit review both for the Scout and Armoured variants in Codex Astra Militarum. In the video we'll talk about their datasheets, talk about their wargear options and Scout versus Armoured Sentinels, a few of the many buffs that you can put on Sentinels, how it comes together in damage output, and how I think about fielding them in-game. Loads to talk about, so let's jump straight in. So the two variants of Sentinel are a couple of different fast attack choices for Codex Astra Militarum. There's the Scout Sentinel and the Armoured Sentinel. They both have their own datasheets, and I'd say they've got more similarities than differences, but they do have a few pros and cons between the two. The Scout Sentinel is a bit cheaper at 40 points, and Sentinels in general do have a whole bunch of very helpful keywords for the Guard. Weirdly, they seem to be about the unit that you can make the most out of just about every character with. Their core platoon models for orders, squadron models for tank orders, and also regimental for your regimental doctrines. It means that they could be getting rerolls from foot infantry characters at the same time as they get buffs from things like a tech priest engine seer or tank orders from a tank commander. Statline-wise, generally the Sentinels are at least fairly fast and durable. The Scout variant are vehicles with a 12-inch move, they hit on 4s, strength and toughness of 6, 7 wounds, 2 attacks, leadership 7, and a 4+ save. Generally as a unit, I'd rate them really good for both durability and pretty speedy as well. Perhaps their biggest weakness is that without a whole bunch of buffs stacking on them, they're kind of bad in terms of damage output. Even with 4+ armor though, 7 wounds at toughness 6 really is no joke for 40 points. It means that both anti-tank and anti-infantry weapons just aren't desperately efficient against them, even though they will be damaged by both. Weapons-wise, all the primary weapons for the Sentinels are free. You get to choose between the autocannon, missile launcher, heavy flamer, las cannon, multi-laser, and plasma cannon. Compared with the last codex, you can take a plasma cannon on the Scout variant now. It only does one mortal wound if you overcharge it on a hit roll of 1. And the multi-laser has been a bit updated since the previous book, 4 attacks at strength 6 and AP minus 1. We'll talk about the different weapon profiles in a second. Otherwise, it's got 2 different upgrades, both for 5 points each. You can take a Hunter Killer missile with a single crack missile shot at strength 10, and a Sentinel chainsaw, which actually makes you into a small combat threat as well, strength 6, AP minus 2, and damage 2, with an extra attack, so 3 per model. Again, that's plus 5 points, and it basically turns it from a model that's got very little close combat threat into one that will fairly reliably at least kill one infantry model each time it fights. Finally, for special rules, the Scout Sentinel's special thing is that it gets to forward deploy. You can set it up anywhere outside of 9 inches of the enemy deployment zone and their models, so you could have it start on midfield objectives or just be in a nuisance place to hold up the enemy. Definitely doesn't hurt to have it a bit more flexible. Overall, they're reasonably fast-moving walkers with fairly low damage but good speed and toughness, a reasonable range of different choices, and the option to get buffed by all manner of things within the Guard book, as we'll get onto. If you compare the datasheet to the armoured one, these guys are a fast attack choice at 45 points. They have the same keywords, but they gain the armoured keyword as well. And statline-wise, for the extra 5 points, the main thing that you're paying for is the 3+ armour save on these. It is going to save them a fair bit of damage compared with that 4+, but you do lose some movement and the forward deployment into the bargain, though. These guys only get a 9-inch move, and they have to set up within your deployment zone. The extra save will be useful, and the armoured keyword gives it a plus 1 save against damage 1 attacks, effectively a 2+ save against those type of things if you've got AP 0, meaning that it's really you're not going to get hurt at all by chip damage. You're going to need to target it with something just a little bit heavier. Wargear-wise, it's basically the same as the Scout Sentinel. Any of the heavy weapons for free, plus the chainsaw and the Hunter Killer missile for 5 points each. For wargear choices, I feel like for the heavy weapons, the plasma cannon does feel like it's just a little bit over the other choices right now. Against toughness 7 vehicles, when it's overcharged, it'll do slightly better than a las cannon, and having more shots usually means that it threatens infantry just a little bit better than most, particularly if they're in bigger squads as well when you get the automatic 3 shots due to the blast rule. Even the overheats isn't so bad when you can very reliably get it some reroll ones to hit from something like a Castellan or a tank order. In general, I'd say that this will be my first pick. I'd say the rest are okay though. The last cannon's not bad for dedicated anti-armour against toughness 8 and things. The heavy flamer's alright for a unit moving into the midfield. And missiles are fairly flexible. Compared with the rest, I'd say the autocannon and multi-laser are perhaps just a little bit underpowered by comparison. I guess if you are lacking a bit of ranged anti-infantry, the multi-laser isn't terrible. I feel like in general, guard lists tend to do anti-infantry pretty well just by their nature though, and need more help against heavies. Otherwise, for both the other bits of wargear, I think that they're both usable in the right situation. The Sentinel Chainswords are kind of fine for frontline units and can actually make the unit into a fairly decent countercharge unit if you need it. Three of them with the Chainswords will get you 9 attacks at AP minus 2 and damage 2, potentially hitting on 3s and AP minus 3 if you give them the combat order. I feel like they're not 100% essential, but pretty reasonable for a vehicle that might well find itself in combat. The Hunter Killer Missile is perhaps again a bit more take or leave. I'd say that if you're not buffing the unit with multiple stacking buffs, then it's probably not worth it just for the 4+ chance to hit. But if you did think that it's going to be starting nearer the core of your army, getting take aim and multiple layers of hit rerolls, then it almost certainly is worth it to help out with the Alpha Strike. When it's getting hit rerolls and AP minus 3, a pretty powerful initial shot for 5 points. In general, my stock loadout will be the Plasma Cannon, and depending on how you're using them, either the Chainsaw or the Hunter Killer Missile or both are reasonably usable if you want. I wouldn't say that either of them are auto-include though, and I think there's a good argument just for keeping them cheap and expendable. Then there's the choice between the Armoured and the Scout Sentinel as to which one you want to run, and for these ones I do feel that Games Workshop has made both of them pretty viable, to be honest. Here's some of the biggest positives for both. For the Scout Sentinel, you get better damage per point as they cost less, 40 points for the same shooting profile as the one for 45, an extra 3-inch movement, so you've got 12 inches rather than 9, that's quite a big deal when you're having to go around terrain and maybe just stretch out to objectives and things. The forward deployment could be really useful as well, having an annoyingly tough and very cheap vehicle starting on midfield objectives and hidden out of line of sight could be something that scores you a few more victory points if your opponent can't get sufficient units to deal with it. Depending on your list though and what secondaries you're taking, it might mean inflexible command scores you a couple of less victory points, though it's still likely to score you very high even if you don't get the tank order thing every turn. I'd also bear in mind that it's actually got better per point durability against some things in the game as well. Mortal wounds and anything like Melter with AP minus 4 or better are actually better taken on Scout Sentinels, as you just get more wounds per point, and neither variant is usually going to be getting a save anyway. For the armoured side of things though, it's basically all trading off against durability. It's got much better per point durability against things like AP minus 0, minus 1 or minus 2. It's very slightly better against AP minus 3, though there isn't much in it. The extra points versus the 6+ save are kind of close, and of course it's got much better durability against any damage 1 attacks due to having armoured and plus 1 saves over the scout. Nice defence against small arms, and particularly any light infantry units that you wind up in combat with. Beyond that, the armoured keyword I guess allows you to use stratagems like minus 1 damage for 2 CP, though unless you've got a big investment unit of 3 sentinels that you're sure that the opponent is going to be focusing down this turn, I feel like that one's a little bit on the pricey side. Overall, I do think that you can make a solid argument for either of them. They're pretty well balanced, to be honest. The Scout Sentinels definitely win the speed and flexibility thing, plus deal more damage per points, but the Armoured Sentinels will be tougher against some of the firepower that matters most, and doubling down on extra durability for a frontline unit like them really isn't the worst thing either. Out of the two, I think I slightly prefer the Scout Sentinels, but honestly there isn't that much in it. Moving on to the various buffs and synergies that you can put on Sentinels, there's a fair few of the regimental traits that help them out. Born Soldiers is very popular and pretty nice for them in general. Certainly helps out plasma cannons and things against hard targets like Toughness 8, and perhaps makes things like the multi-laser just a little bit more tempting than it would be otherwise. Beyond that though, they can get lots of benefits for various different traits. I probably wouldn't pick the trait based on the Sentinels alone, it's more about the rest of the army, but lots of these could be useful. Veteran Guerrillas could have you ignoring cover, never a bad thing. Expert Bombardiers means that you probably want some Sentinels on the list to allow artillery better to hit rolls against certain units nearby. Armoured Superiority is really good if you're going all vehicles. Sentinels counter 3 models on objectives, which could be nice in combination with the OPSEC order. Heirloom Weapons is maybe not super relevant for most of them, but a plus 4 inches on Flamer variants would be nice if you're using those. Trophy Hunters is probably a bit inferior to Born Soldiers overall, but I guess plus 1 strength to attack monsters and vehicles could be quite nice for certain weapons. Again, the Plasma Cannons versus Toughness 8 are helped out big by that. Elite Sharpshooters gives you a single reroll to hit each time you shoot. Running individual units, that gets very efficient on them. Maybe a little bit more of an argument for Las Cannons, but again is pretty excellent on Plasma Cannons due to being able to reroll a single hit roll of 1 where you might take a mortal wound, and it makes the Hunter Killer Missile just a little bit more efficient as well. Recon Operators allows infantry and sentinels to gain a 6-inch pre-game move, never a bad thing for getting lines of sight or hiding somewhere safe if necessary. More useful for armoured sentinels though, as it has to be one set up in your deployment zone. And finally, Swift as the Wind makes sentinels even faster. An extra 2-inch move means things like scout sentinels are rocketing around the board at 14-inch move based, and can go even faster with orders if you like. Could get them right in the enemy's face to do some move blocking. Overall, plenty of interesting stuff. Born soldiers are certainly fine though with the damage output, but if you're trying to make some sort of all-vehicle list work, then armoured superiority is quite good fun, and a lot of the rest of them, if you're running them, could really change how you load your sentinels and how you might use them for their battlefield role. Orders next, and sentinels are crazily flexible, being able to take any of the three tables of orders, unlike anything else in the Codex. For the most part, I feel like the regimental ones are more efficient on them, due to them usually being a bit more limited to slightly less damage-dealing infantry, and the tank orders maybe have just a little bit less value. Depending on the situation though, both are really useful. I'd say probably the stock one to use just about every turn, unless you're doing something else with them, would probably be take aim. A plus one to hit and an extra AP minus one better at range means that they actually go to being okay damage dealers rather than flat out bad ones. Plasma cannons feel a lot better when they're hitting on threes and AP minus four, and it certainly helps out the lower AP weapon variants as well. Otherwise, a lot of the rest of the table is useful. Fixed bayonets for a plus one to hit and an extra AP minus one better in melee is actually genuinely threatening on a big unit of three sentinels. If you've got the chainsaws, you've got an average of 6 hits at strength 6, AP 3, and damage 2. That's almost certainly going to be killing at least a couple of Space Marines, potentially more if you roll well. Take cover, I think, is really quite nice as well. If their damage output just isn't going to be that meaningful this turn, then why not throw this on? This will give them light cover, particularly on the armoured sentinels, that makes them just that extra bit more durable, effectively a 2 plus save versus ranged damage, and makes them do their durability job better. Move, move, move gives you an extra 2-inch movement and automatically advancing 6 inches. Pretty spectacular movement out of sentinels here. These scout ones will be zooming 20 inches across the board. Could be good for move blocking the enemy or jumping on isolated objectives. It does sacrifice their damage output, but if you need to achieve something, then that's probably not the biggest deal with sentinels being what they are. They could also use suppression fire as well, or shoot at one infantry unit and hand out a minus one to hit. You do need 5 hits on the target though, so it's probably going to be more useful if you've got heavy flamers or multi-lasers compared with plasma cannons. Otherwise, for the commissar orders, maybe perhaps the most useful one might be at all costs for objective secured. They can move fairly fast and might be tough enough to charge an enemy unit and not die, so throwing objective secured on them before that might be able to flip an objective. Otherwise, there's options for advancing and shooting as if stationary, falling back and shooting, saves against mortal wounds, and screening out deep strike. Lastly, we've got the mechanized orders, either from a Lord Solar, a Warlord trait or an officer, or perhaps a tank commander. Pound them to dust allows you to count blast weapons as double the number of models in the target unit. Say if you're firing your plasma cannons against a unit of, say, 3 obliterators or Gravis armoured space marines, then that would often be more damage output than take aim, though there isn't a whole load in it if the AP matters. Full throttle gives you an extra 2-inch movement and can shoot even if you're advanced. Very nice if you want loads of movement, plus you also want to fire a bit. A little bit slower than move, 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 but not much. Gunner's kill on sight can give you reroll ones to hit, definitely less effective than take aim against the vast majority of things. If take aim isn't an option and you want a damage boost though, I guess this one helps out with plasma cannon overheats too. Blitz them can make them charge a bit better. Shock and awe is another way to gain them objective secured as well. And pinning fire is another situational one for firing at enemy infantry units. If you're not taking multi-lasers or heavy flamers, then it's probably not worth it. Overall, a crazy amount of options here. Out of all this stuff, I'd feel that the most usable ones are take aim and take cover for raw extra damage and defence, and then objective secured or the various different options for boosting speed as well, if you want your sentinels zooming over to objectives or move blocking the enemy and things. I feel that between all of these, it means that sentinels are quite good with officers with flexible orders that they can give, say an officer with superior tactical training, or having Lord Solar somewhere nearby for just all the choices. Speaking of other character buffs for them, as mentioned, I feel that Lord Solar is quite a good fit with them. He can potentially give them 4 rerolls to hit and wound as well with his big reroll thing. That could be kind of efficient on, say, a unit of armoured sentinels with plasma cannons and hunter-killer missiles turn 1. But even if you are going all out for maximum damage output, I can't help but think it's usually just going to be more efficient on something like Kazakin, or even like a Lehman Russ battle tank. If it is just 3 plasma cannons in a unit, then even with maximal rerolls, it might be better elsewhere unless the other thing that he wanted to buff was dead. If he's nearby though, he can certainly grant his passive rerolls to these guys as well. Definitely helpful to try and keep nearby if it's possible and it doesn't conflict with whatever role you wanted him to do in the army too much. Otherwise, the various commandants are nice for plasma cannons in particular for rerolling those ones. The command squad standard can be nice for rerolling ones to wound as well, which can stack. And out of the special characters, besides Lord Solar, Creed is pretty good for the plus 1 strength, maybe strength 9 plasma cannons, or even strength 8 without overcharging. Within the command squad, I feel like perhaps the single most useful relic for them is the Finial of the Nemridesh First. This again is a very nice one to be able to get on big scary guns like the Sentinel plasma cannons. It allows you to ignore to hit roll modifiers, feel no pain type saves, and damage caps. Three pretty important barriers to damage there, and I'd be very tempted to take this on a command squad that's going to be hanging out near some Sentinels. Finally, for other minor characters, a Primaris Psyker really isn't terrible. If you had a big unit of, say, three armoured Sentinels, giving them a 5 plus invul save and Night Shroud are both nice boosts. I'd say maybe a bit take or leave though, given that they're already reasonably tough already. And a Tet Priest Engine Seer is alright, gives a 5 plus invul save automatically and heals them a bit. The 5 plus invul only affects one model though, and to be honest, healing them maybe isn't the most efficient use of him. I feel like he's just going to be a lot better healing wounds on bigger, tougher and more expensive tanks, things like say a Rogal Dawn or a Leban Ross Tank Commander. Sentinel wounds are kind of cheap to come by, you might be better just buying an extra Sentinel rather than buying him. Out of these, lots of usable stuff. I do feel that Sentinels get on particularly well with just being towards the core of your army, with command squads, commandants, and maybe that relic standard nearby. They can get a lot of extra damage without much effort. Stratagems next, and I would say that as Sentinels are cheap, I probably wouldn't go too overboard with command points and things. If you're running things like Russes or Kazakin, you're probably better off using damage and durability things on those rather than the Sentinels. I feel like they're usually just going to be a bit more efficient. The Sentinels do have their own unique stratagem called Maverick Maneuvers, which could be, again, pretty excellent for the movement buff. You get to move an extra 6 inches after shooting for the Sentinels, which means that potentially with that tank order, you could have them going crazy distances. I believe with the tank order for extra movement and advancing, you'd be getting around about a 23 or 24 inch move out of a scout sentinel with that. Potentially could be handy as well for moving up, shooting off some shots, and then jumping behind terrain onto an objective, making it a lot more of a pain to deal with. Otherwise, acceptable losses means that you can potentially shoot things that are in combat with sentinels. Might make sense if you didn't want to fall back. There's a couple of nice durability ones if you just want to make them even more of a nuisance to take down. Smoke launchers for 1 CP for minus 1 to hit, or ablative plating for 2 CP for minus 1 damage. In general, unless it's absolutely mission critical and it might make a difference, then I'd generally not want to use those on individual sentinels as they're just not efficient enough. If you think that it might give them a actual reasonable chance of surviving though, and that survival might earn you some victory points, in particular smoke launchers seem like they could be okay against certain attacks. Otherwise, there's a few slightly situational damage boosts. Things like Vengeance for Cadia, if you're near a Cadian officer for a plus 1 to wound against Chaos, Overlapping Fields for rerolls and extra AP should you need it, and Ingrained Precision for auto-wounding on a 5+, maybe particularly nice if you have the Lord Solar rerolls. For the most part though, I think you're usually going to be better off saving the CP for buffing more dangerous units, at least from damage. Talking of damage output though, I thought it just might be interesting to see what some Battleland Sentinels can do. Here we have the shooting for 3 Sentinels with plasma cannons, should cost you around about 120 to 150 points, depending on what variant that you're running and what upgrades you're taking. The idea for these is 3 Sentinels clustered around the core of your army. We're maybe being a little bit generous and saying reroll ones to hit some wounds from a commandant and a command squad. Someone's giving them the take aim order to splash to the other Sentinels for a plus 1 to hit and AP minus 4, and they've also got the Finial of the Nemridesh First within range of them as well. Won't be relevant for any of these numbers, but if the opponent had any modifiers, damage caps or feel no pain, they'd basically be negators. For just 3 plasma cannons with those rerolls, you'd kill around about 7 guardsmen, that's assuming that the blast rule would be active for a squad of 6 or more. They're very nice against space marines, around about 4 dead, or around about 5 or 6 if the blast rule triggers. You'd kill around about 1 or 2 space marine terminators, about 7 wounds to a toughness 7 vehicle, but they are significantly more underwhelming against hard targets. Against, say, a toughness 8 vehicle with a minus 1 damage and 5 plus invul, you're only doing about 2 wounds, as it's extra tough against high AP and damage 2 things. Overall, those numbers get into the region of being kind of okay, but not spectacular. I think that the numbers are perhaps just fairly impressive, considering how tanky they are for the cost, and you could have all of that for 120 points just hanging around the core of your army that can buff other things too. But even with fairly big investment, they don't outshoot Russes, unless they have damage boosts that the Finial standard can negate. I feel like if you were going with all of these buffs, it's probably worth adding the 3 Hunter Killer missiles for the Alpha Strike as well. That would make all the numbers way better against armoured targets for the first turn of firing. And I think it's kind of interesting that you could be very flexible with the numbers for these guys. You could easily expand this out to 9 Sentinels if you wanted a really durable battle line with a lot of plasma fire. All of these buffs can easily spread across multiple units without real effort. Overall, I will be very tempted to add a few Sentinels into a guard list. They're quite a nice mix of a unit that can deal some decent damage if needed, but more importantly, are just a really nice thing to have on the front line. Really quite tough, and might draw fire from important things like Rosses, and they're also cheap enough to be expendable and be putting forward onto objectives and things, and if, say, the opponent is forced to charge them to try and kill them, hopefully they'll be exposing their units so you can delete them in turn and trade out quite nicely. Just for my own rough instincts, I'd generally be tempted to take Scout Sentinels over the Armoured ones, but I'd be kind of happy with either. I'd field them in individual units until the fast attack slots got full, and then consider squadrons if you really want to go Sentinel heavy. I would equip them with the Plasma Cannons, though I feel like a fair few of the other heavy weapon options are pretty viable depending on what regimental doctrine you use. And if you are going for maximal investment with rerolls and things, probably stick on the Hunter Killer missiles as well. And also think about the Chainsaws if you've got a few points left over in your list. For support, they could easily have just nothing whatsoever and be individual little nuisance units moving forward onto objectives, but they get on particularly well with the command squad with that Finial, or Lord Solar if they can sneak inside his buffing aura, and he's not too busy doing something more important with bigger threatening units. For their battlefield role, I think perhaps one of the most powerful things about them in-game is they just have some really good options. You could cluster them all around your buffing units for the first few turns for some firepower and scoring those inflexible command points. And then perhaps the biggest decision each turn is which orders to use, whether you're just going for more damage with take aim, making them tougher with take cover, or zooming them out to objectives or using objectives secured for them. I'd be particularly tempted to go for objective type things later in the game, using good movement plus the orders or their obsec to zoom onto objectives, and hopefully take a few key points towards the end. In the meantime though, generally I'd want them to be trying to make themselves a bit more obtrusive and draw fire from things like Lehman Rosses, potentially even affording to nuisance charge certain enemies that can't quite kill them in combat, or even using their good movement and orders to zoom up and move block the enemy. Potentially a few of those could even keep the enemy pinned in their deployment zone for a turn, which could be pretty disastrous for certain armies like perhaps Knights. If you feel like you're very likely to score very high on inflexible command anyway, you could also just run them fairly dispersed on midfield objectives, ideally hiding out of line of sight on points that your opponent might struggle to contest, and put an annoying vehicle that they can't kill on them and score you some primary points. Overall, a really solid utility unit. I think it's hard to go too far wrong with some Sentinels, particularly if you do have a few support options available to them. Overall, as you can probably tell from the general tone of the video, I would currently rate Sentinels as a top tier unit for the Guard, and in general, I'd expect to see them run in most competitive lists, though not always in large numbers. Just a few for disruption and annoyance, and a bit of speed and durability on objectives, backed up with mainline damage dealers like Lehman Rosses and Kazakin and things like that. In terms of competitors for the various things that they do, as mentioned, I do think that Lehman Rosses will win firefights better than Sentinels at the moment, even when they have all the buffs. I feel like it's probably more optimal to just run a few Sentinels to screen and take the brunt of the damage, as opposed to going super heavy on them, but I certainly think it could be fun to run a massive 18 Sentinel list and just have a whole bunch of very tough firepower that the opponent's going to struggle to kill. I guess Rough Riders might give them a bit of competition for the fast attack slots if you want to run them. In general, I feel like people are going to run more Sentinels than Rough Riders just due to the utility of the units, and Rough Riders being a bit easier to kill for their cost. Still though, could put a little bit of pressure on the Sentinels, who usually want to hog the fast attack slots and run individual units. Otherwise, I guess for their battlefield role, infantry kind of do rival them a bit for that. They kind of have a similar role, limited damage output, but at least reasonably tough to slog through, and good flexibility with the orders, and perhaps more importantly, objective secured. In general, I feel like infantry working with Sentinels might not be a bad idea. They've got a lot of similarities, and the infantry can do some things like move through ruined walls and bring objectives secured, which the Sentinels generally won't have without orders. Overall, a very solid unit, definitely one that you can justify running in the Guard at the moment, I think. So anyway, I think we'll leave that there for our overview of the Chicken Walkers of the Imperial Guard in 40k at the moment. Let me know your thoughts on them down in the comments below. How have you been using Sentinels in your army lists, and what are your favourite ways to run them? If you've enjoyed the video, then feel free to subscribe to Auspex Tactics. I'll certainly keep the regular Guard videos coming, and feel free to check out my other ones on the channel. We've done a bunch of unit reviews, and if you want to see one for another fast attack choice for the Guard, then check out the one on Hellhounds, which I'll link down in the video description. Finally, if you've been enjoying all the videos on the channel, I would just like to mention that Auspex Tactics does have a Patreon page as well, and that's the thing that allows me to keep on making videos like this quite so often. If you have been enjoying quite a bit, any support is enormously appreciated. Channel patrons do get a fair few advantages, seeing certain videos early, regular votes to see what sort of things come next on the channel, and automatic entry into the regular prize giveaways with a chance to win some big model kits every month. If any of that sounds good to you or you'd just like to help support, the link is down in the video description. In any case, an enormous thank you for listening, and I'll hope to see you guys next time.